COVID-19?
COVID-19.
I blow the wind of God.
The wind of God.
On you.
On you.
You are destroyed forever, and you will never be back.
And you'll never be back.
Thank you, Ark.
You're sneezing, I'm subject, while at the grocery. Corona, so badly, now go 6 feet from me.
Yeah, you like that?
What was that?
So my stepdad, he made a comedy parody, a parody song of the Police, Don't Stand So Close to Me for COVID. So I added the Kenneth Copeland preacher guy going, COVID-19!
That was so ridiculous. The whole kind of like, get away from us, COVID-19! And like, have you heard about the church that are still meeting? It's like,
what?
Yeah, there are churches that are still meeting nearby.
Yeah.
And there's a church I know, I don't want to out them, but they're near me, and they are going to have people, like, there's 40 parking spots. They're having a drive-in thing with Easter baskets and breakfast. I'm like, I don't even think it's wise to have people in their cars near each other. I'm like, just stay online.
I don't mind the drive-up, because they can drive up, grab the stuff, and leave. I don't mind too much.
It still makes me, like, nervous. Yeah.
Nauseous? Yeah, gotcha.
Yeah.
No, yeah, so even our church, I think for Palm Sunday around here, we're like, not my church, but like the churches, I guess, are doing the whole, you can drive up and get your palms for Palm Sunday and stuff. COVID-19! Oh. That guy is creepy looking. Have you ever seen him? Kenneth Copeland. Look him up, dude. He looks the devil.
And there's like a video like, I don't want to be in an airplane full of demons. And I mean, he has Kenneth Copeland, I'm sorry, he's in it for the money. He's in it for the fame. Yeah.
Oh, my the dad. Eyes. My dad actually had experience with him. My dad used to be a minister when we lived in Florida. And when we moved up here, we started going. I don't go to church anymore, but after my dad moved up here and got rid of his other churches, he met Kenneth Copeland and was like studying under him and all that. And then my dad said, fuck this, I'm out. And he's like, I can't do this. This shit is crazy. So he just got out of it.
Wow.
Yeah, man.
Them crazies, I tell you. I don't know. Yeah. I've never been big on. I went to. Okay, so can I tell a little story real quick?
It's a money thing. Yeah, go for it.
Yeah. So I know what you mean. When I was younger, I fancied this girl.
I know what you mean.
Whoa, where's this echo coming from?
I fancied this girl.
I know what you mean. That's coming from Norco Killer.
God damn it.
Now we know where the echo came from.
Wait, no. No, that was from.
I think I forgot to send Twitch over or something, but that was my fault.
Are we doing video
today? Just reset Twitch?
No, I just want audio.
Okay, why? You're not just pretty enough, Frasley?
No, I got in here too late.
I think you're pretty, Fraz. Okay.
Oh, thank you.
That's fine. As long as you're streaming, right? So we're streaming on the
absolutely.
Website.
We're streaming and all that. The first few minutes, I thought we were live to it, but I didn't. I don't know.
I haven't checked Twitch to make sure it wasn't, and then it just started.
So I think I forgot to send the audio. Oh yeah, yes, yeah. Go on with Kenneth.
Yeah, go with your story, buddy.
My story, okay. So. I fancied this girl, right? I had a huge crush on her, and she was a non-denominational Christian girl or something like that. And this is a weird time in my life where I was like in my early 20s, stupid, you know, and I decided that I was going to go to her church to, you know, try to do a little hubba, 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 right? Well, I come in, I'm wearing a white zombie shirt, you know, underneath a biker jacket, because at the time we were all into bikes and stuff. Had my long ass goatee, earring in an ear, bald head, and I'm standing in the back at first. And she kind of looks back and she goes, oh, and she's like, come on, come on, come on. So I go up and I sit in the front pew with her. And within like, I want to say 10 minutes, the preacher comes like, cause he's staring at me at first. Cause obviously I stick out like a sore thumb. And, then the preacher comes out and starts talking to me and he goes, do you want to become a Christian? I was like, yeah, sure.
Why are you yelling at me, sir? Yeah.
And he goes, come on up. And I'm like, oh, God, I got it. So I get up and I'm on the altar, right?
Now that's their sales pitch starting.
On the altar. And there's this big old canvas, like lambskin stretched out thing that had markings on it from Genesis till now. And he goes, are you a sinner? I was like, yeah, I'm a sinner. And then he goes, look at this. I can predict the next 20 years of your life. It's like, really? Cool. What am I going to do? Am I going to be rich? Am I going to get, married? What is going to happen? You know, because I'm like, are you serious? This guy is nuts, man.
So you were patronizing him, obviously.
A little bit. He's spitting while he talks. I mean, and then he like grabs my head and was all like, we need to heal this child. And I keep, there's a lot of echo. Needless to say, I don't know. But needless to say, it didn't work out too well. Because I get done with all that stuff. I get a fucking awesome looking Bible, right? And these people all signed it. They're all like happy. They're all like cultists, man. It was really cool. Why don't you come over to our house for chicken, Paul? And we do all that. And then finally, I'm all like, so. Yeah, you want to go on a date or something? I have to pray on it. And then I never heard from her again.
Oh, man. I was going to ask if you hit it.
Yeah, no, she went. She went, none of this. I was like, this is bullshit. I wasted a whole night of this because I'm Catholic. And that's the, I don't know. I just laughed when this guy goes, do you want to be saved? I kind of was at confirmation with the Catholics, I think.
Oh, I gotta pray on it. Why don't you just think about it?
I know, dude. That was such a smack in the face. I was like, what?
That means I gotta go sit in my room and ask myself if this
this is burly biker dude. Well, he's short, so
right.
Yeah. Remember that from last show about being short? Okay. Never mind.
Yeah.
Okay. So, how's everybody doing? How are they having this? My long thing kind of sucked. But how did everybody do? How's everybody dealing with the quarantine?
I've been watching Star Trek every morning with friends and enjoying that. Been streaming every day. So. And I'm also going to go for a walk this afternoon. So it's finding ways to stay sane
and stay 6 feet from everyone, please.
Oh, absolutely. And we also, our family put together masks now. So when we're out, have to be more than 6 feet. Like if I go into like a store, we have masks that as soon as we get back home, we'll throw back into the wash. I know that they're not like masks don't stop it, but by making our own masks, at least we have one more precaution.
My friend went.
So what did you use to make them?
Your mom's bra.
What the, how do you know? I was gonna say like one of my friends made it out of a diaper, but yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what the fabric is. All I know is my mom made it, and she made it out of the fabric that they recommended. So I don't know.
Is it the plush? The feel of cotton?
Think so? I don't know. I don't know. As I wore it, it looks
no
cool.
One catches
so
the joke.
Is it lacy?
a little bit. It provides me a lot of good support.
Does it? Does it make you feel like a real woman?
Absolutely.
So somebody put out a I guess it was a source app, open source code. So if you have a 3D printer where it will print you up like brackets and stuff to make a mask with. So, I need a 3D printer. And if anybody's interested in Venmoing me some money so that I can buy a 3D printer.
Shameless.
If anybody has a 3D printer, can you just 3D print money. Me a 3D printer?
Can you just 3D print yet? Some money for us? That'd be great. Oh my goodness. Shameless. No, okay, this is not going anywhere and I'm gonna need to pay attention. Okay, focus time. All right.
All right.
So we got some listener mail. We got some shout outs to do today. And I want to talk a little bit about COVID-19 since it's, you know, no one talks about that anymore.
No.
It's so they said the coronavirus stimulus checks. We're going to talk about that. But did you hear about how it's peaking right now?
Well, they had two days where it didn't go up. So it didn't spike.
Because we were watching the news last night, and everybody keeps talking about this is the peak period. No one needs to go out at all for the next several weeks. And I'm like,
yeah, huh. I don't really think they should be telling people it's peaking. And then you're gonna have people who are just like, fuck it, I'm just gonna go outside anyway.
Well, yeah, I'm like that already.
And we're already finding people that are.
I go for walks, Fraz.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, I do too. Hey, walks are good, but like I'm finding people that are also being like, oh well, it's an overreaction. And someone's like, well, no, it's not an overreaction because by doing what we did, we are getting ahead of the curve. But if we had not done this, we actually might be worse off than we are. And
yeah,
absolutely.
I agree with you there, Fraz.
Absolutely.
I mean, I'm you know all for you know taking care of things, blah blah blah. You know that.
I'm really surprised. Are you guys really surprised at how much the American public has actually followed the whole stay at home thing?
Actually, yeah.
I am actually.
Last several days, the Illinois around the area where I'm at, they just completely just shut down now. They're at home.
Well, yeah. Illinois, last figures I looked at, the state of Illinois had like 1,300 deaths.
Yeah.
Really?
Well, I'm just.
And like Missouri maybe had less than 200, I think.
Well, pin a rose in your nose.
Well, you know, no, I mean, people are dying from this stuff, man. Yeah. And it's nothing to mess around with.
No. And thinking, because I mean, I'm one of those who took it for granted. Like, it's never going to happen to me. But we just found out one of our friends is getting tested for it right now. Right, Aaron?
That is correct. Yeah. I think it'll be okay.
Oh, I hope so.
I honestly think I've already had it. Like I told you, I never get headaches and rarely get sick. And there was a time as soon as this all started, I had a friend that felt the same way, except I got headaches for 2 weeks straight. But I kept my ass at home for 3 weeks after that. So
I
don't know.
Like I was saying, I think this was before then because I remember having the worst flu that I had in previous times last year, where I had trouble breathing, everything. Like, it was nasty. So, is what it is. All right.
Yeah.
So, let's talk about the stimulus. Everybody ready for their stimulus, Jax?
Mm-hmm. I don't already know what I'm going to spend mine on, but, you know.
East side.
Negative. The Ruger 5.7.
Damn, that's that expensive? Wow.
Yeah, it's like $600.
Well, then what are you going to do with the other 600?
Eastside.
Maybe I'll pay a bill. Honestly, I won't pay. I don't want to pay all that money just to be frustrated. So I won't go to the Eastside.
Oh, nice. Good point. Well, they rub you up too. From 6 feet away now, so you're okay.
So they're going to use like one of those painter's rolls or something.
Like that, and they give you, when you walk in, they give you one of those old people grabbers.
You're going to like walk through the spray of, push the button, walk through the spray of hand sanitizer.
Yeah. That'd be kind of cool. She has a face mask on and shit.
Yeah.
Oh, good times.
That Ruger 5.7 is weird.
Do you have a picture of it?
Oh yeah, I'm looking at it now. I'll post it for you.
That'd be nice.
What rounds are those?
5-7 rounds.
Whoa. I figured so, but
is it gas powered?
It's a semi-automatic handgun.
Oh, it's a hand. Well, he said Ruger. My name is Pearl. Yeah. I don't know that much about Ruger guns. Makes rifles. Why am I even trying? Well, they estimate 175 million Americans will get the stimulus checks, with the first payments going out this week or next, according to Larry Kudlow, director of the U.S. National Economic Council. What do you guys think? I don't think it's going to hit me by any chance anytime soon. Because
I think we got some time, just being in the middle of the country.
We'll see. And then when is the unemployment 600 a week supposed to kick in? Huh? We don't even know that either. I called the labor board,
I got an email about that today.
Hmm.
And I'll pull it up, and it says the Federal CARES Act legislation provides that eligible claimants shall receive an additional $600 per week payment. This payment to eligible claimants will begin for the week ending April 4th, 2020, and will continue until the week ending July 25th, 2020. Unemployment benefits, including this additional $600 per week payment, are subject to federal and state income taxes.
Yeah, and I'm glad you brought that up about the income tax. So we're going to get taxed on a stimulus, which is our tax money.
Actually, it's not. The guy that I was looking at earlier today said that it is not taxable.
That's what they're saying. However, you bring up a good point. I looked this stuff up. I fact checked and everything. What is this stimulus we have? They consider it, the government does, as a tax credit, not a stimulus. An actual stimulus check is saying that they took our money and they give it back to us because they're rerouting it to whatever we need, right, to help us out. But they're considering it a tax credit. So if you next year, not this year, but next year when you file, it's going to deduct that from your return. How nice is that?
Wow.
Now, if I'm wrong and all these articles online are wrong, please tell me, everyone, and I guess we'll never know till next year. And if that's the truth, I don't even know if I want to spend it. So,
can you imagine the uproar? Because the media is not covering that. Can you imagine the uproar if everyone knew that? I didn't know that.
Well, we need to dive deeper.
That's crazy.
You remember when we did the stimulus last week show, and I said, wait. Trump said 6.2 million. The stimulus that we have everywhere says 2.2. And then they said there's 25 million extra for some federal JFK museum and all this other stuff. But point of my story is, are we seeing the whole picture or not?
I have no idea.
That's what I'm saying. I don't know. And it's pissing me off. Thoughts, anyone?
Well, and it sucks that, you know, you can't get anything through Congress. It's like, hey, let's put $1 million towards fixing the roads. And they're like, yeah. And while we're at it, let's just go ahead and allot, you know, another $3 million just to, you know, put a new toilet in the White House. You know?
Yeah.
It's this whole quid pro quo system that they have where, you know, they'll hide some of the obscurest stuff inside of a bill just so that money can be rerouted.
I get some of it because this stalled some bills that were pending that they were trying to push through. So there's just, you know, they're tagging on to get it to go through with something else. And, you know, I get some of it, but it is a little bit.
But you're not going to be really buying that many goods and services. So if you think about it, you pump all this money into a quote unquote stimulus package. What can we spend it on other than bills and essentials, basically, if everything's closed?
It's a survival.
You're just routing it for people who have to pay bills. You're just routing it back to these corporations.
These corporations are
not going to get as much money as they would considering they're getting money from us to pay for the electric. I can pretty much
guarantee mine's all going to Home Depot because I'm rebuilding my deck as all this is.
Right. And it's like, I would probably, honestly, you know what, Polly, what I'll do with that other $600 of that stimulus package? I'm going to buy a shipping container and bury it in my backyard and make it a fallout shelter.
There you go. There you go. Here we go.
Make my own fallout shelter.
A stimulus check guns are technically an advance of a special tax credit for the 2020 year tax year. Some tax credits reduce your overall tax bill. The more credits you claim, the less in taxes you'll have to owe. But other tax credits, such as the earned income tax credit, are refundable, meaning that if you don't owe any federal income taxes, the government sends you a check for the credit. In essence, they're payments from the government delivered to the IRS. The stimulus payment is uniquely fully tax refundable credit, even if you don't owe a penny in a tax. You get the full 1200, yeah. So you get the full 1200, even if you didn't file or whatever this year, or you're not getting much back. But next year they're going to deduct that. Yeah.
Okay. Giving myself a loan.
A credit, not an actual stimulus check. Because I looked up stimulus checks, and stimulus checks, like, if you're, the definition of a stimulus check is, it does not get taxed. However, that's true. It doesn't get taxed, but you will have to claim it next year on your taxes because it's a credit to your next year's tax return. So what they're basing it is, okay, you make $2,000 a year in taxes at the end of the year or whatever. Now we're just going to deduct $1,200 from that next time because we gave you it earlier. That's what pisses me off. No, you didn't. You didn't give us shit. This is our tax money, you asshole. This is what – we are the most taxed. We tax – the most we put in with our taxes – it pays off so much, but the government just, and I don't mean government, I meant the politicians, just keep stealing from us and we do nothing about it. All right, I think
it's worse in Canada.
It's worse in Canada?
Well, I have a Canadian friend of mine who lives in the States now, and he explained to me about how the first 6 months of the year, the Canadian government takes dang near 50% of their income for taxes, but it lightens up on after like Boxing Day or whatever in Canada, which it's usually somewhere around like June, July ish. Once they have that day, they know that after that day, they're pretty much going to get all of their paychecks in.
Hmm.
So they are taxed at a higher rate in Canada, but on the tail end, it really, really lightens up.
Well, and that really fucks you over because if you're a salary and you pay your taxes throughout the year, well, they jack you for their taxes at the beginning of the year. And let's say you lose your job, then they've already got their money. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. You know, it's funny. Every time we try to talk politics on the show, it just kind of doesn't feel like it's flowing right.
It falls off.
Yeah, it's just kind of, yeah. I don't know why that is. Maybe it's just because people do not want to
sound like Alex Jones, and none of us can match that.
What do you mean? Oh, my raging hatred towards Republicans and Democrats? Yes.
The frogs are gay.
Yeah, I don't. I'm not a good person when it comes to thinking about politics. So.
I don't follow everything enough to comment. I'll just sound like an idiot.
Yeah.
I would like to know when that $600 gets tacked onto the unemployment thing, though.
Me too. So
I haven't gotten a disbursement yet. So
yeah. I called the Missouri Labor Union, right, or the Missouri Labor Board, or whatever it's called, and they have an automated thing saying that they don't know when either. It's when the government gets a hold of them, because the government is saying they don't have the technology to put it in yet.
Yeah.
So if we're peaking right now and we all stay in our little hovels and do what we need to do, and then like in 2 weeks we all go back to work, and then they don't have to worry about paying us the stimulus, that's really going to irk me, because I was really looking forward to have an extra $600 a paycheck.
And to be honest, if it's the state of Missouri, you know, you're getting, making more money on unemployment than you would at your actual job. Because well, if it's 320, it's 320 a week.
Yes.
And I opted to have them take out 10% for the taxes.
I did too. Yep.
So 10% of $320 is $32. So you're looking at what, $280 plus the extra $600 for, you know, like $680 a week. That's
not going to get you very far at Roxy's.
No.
But no, I'm not going to say if that
it'll go far. Enough, it'll go. It'll good. Definitely. It'll definitely go far at a gun store.
Yeah.
Well, we should be getting the main stimulus pretty soon, so we'll see about that.
Yeah.
Well, and you know, little by little, I'm just nibbling off my tax return anyway. So, but I am, since the kids are home, and I'm burning through like $200 of groceries every week and a half or so.
Oh yeah, yeah. It's staying at home sucks.
And it's mostly just now, like when I went grocery shopping Monday, I went grocery shopping. Now the stores are starting to restock everything. So, you know, you do have meat, and I did find toilet paper and paper towels and all of that stuff that was just gone. You still can't find, I'm finding bleach, but you're still not finding Lysol spray or anything like that.
Oh, wow. Come to the Walmart and Aldi where I am at. Dude, they're fully back stocked up. They just have restrictions on things. Like you can only take two of this and stuff.
Yeah. Well, like I was looking for yeast. So I mean, I've got flour.
That's not
flour.
Bleach or Lysol.
No, but I was looking for yeast just in case I had to make bread. So
making looks bread. Like,
looks like B Dism's going to be selling a lot of bread this summer.
Dude. Banana bread this way, baby. Same.
Oh man, and you know it's jacked up. I bought two things of bananas, and I've already yesterday for Brenner, I made banana pancakes, and it was so good.
Oh, if I didn't have to stay 6 feet away from you, I'd come over to your house and eat your food.
Hey man, you're welcome over at Chateau B Dism anytime, brother.
Chateau B Dism. Oh, that's nice. Love it. Chateau B Dism.
Come on through, man. We can play Sega all night.
Alright. So let's Sega. Let's do a quick shout out. We got Johnny K shout out right now. He sent some listener mail in for
Johnny
us.
K.
Yeah.
So
Johnny K. I like the name John and Johnny.
John. Okay, so here's what he writes. Years ago, I listened to a podcast that I found funny and fun. A couple of guys did a serious review on Fast and Furious movies one at a time. Perhaps your team would like to do something similar. Here are some suggestions. Bad Boys, Deadpool, this would be tough to make a mock out of it, but I love the shit talk in it. 80s and 90s Batman movies. The 89 Batman was legendary, but the mid-90s finished poorly. Okay. And Transformers movies. I want to suggest movies that were fun and can prompt comments for everyone. Sincerely, Johnny K. Thanks, Johnny.
Thanks, Johnny.
I
hope he's not going to ask for money because he just gave us show ideas for like the next 3 weeks.
I know, dude.
Oh, yeah.
He's a badass mother, and he don't take no shit off.
Like on TV, I was hearing that
you don't like tug on Superman's cape. Wait,
okay. I was hearing like that. Like writers always have to turn away any ideas that they hear from people because people will come back like, "Hey, I demand a royalty for that."
Oh well, Johnny K, if you demand a royalty, you're shit out of luck because we still can't sell anything on the damn website.
So. We'll give you. We got a Funko Pop with your name on it.
There we go. Right. Wait, no, we're down to the last one. The one after this is the Bob Ross one.
Might be able to get a discount on some nitro.
You know what? I need to round out some purchases to make it $25 on Amazon. So I'll buy like a Funko Pop.
There you go. Oh man, you need to buy some t-shirts from us, man. Oh, yeah. We need to get toilet paper made in a Miss Lane's podcast. Then we'll always be selling out. Okay, so we got that. You know what? I'm down for that. I would love to start with Batman, dude. If we're going to do it, we got to start with a great Batman, you know? Mm-hmm. So That's my opinion. Thoughts?
Eating Batman.
So there you go. Cheapest Funko Pop that they got on Amazon right now is a Triple H Skull King collectible figure.
Skull King. Nice.
Or an L337 Star Wars Funko Pop. There you go.
Hey, Frasley, can I ask you a personal question about World of Warcraft? Not to interrupt you, I'm sorry.
Oh, sure. Yeah, well, what's up?
Not to interrupt you, BDism, I'm sorry. Is it just me or the DPS when you're tanking are like little friggin' punk kids that are all hopped up on heroin because all they want to do is unleash hell and you can't hold any aggro on anyone because they're like, woo-hoo, and then just like,
are you working on your threat?
Yes, I'm working on my threat.
Oh, okay, good. Because if you're not working on your threat, then there's a problem, people? Okay? You really got to work on your threat, Polly.
No, yeah, I know what you mean. They're always like, hey, I want to do stuff and I don't want to use threat meters. I don't want to, like, accidentally do the thing that the tanks are working on because I want to get to this dungeon as fast as I can so I can go to bed at 10 p.m. because my parents have a curfew.
Then they're going to post it. I mean, I leave groups now when they annoy me. I'm just like, nope, not going to happen. Or they'll start pooling for you because obviously you're taking too long.
Yeah.
And I've played video games at like 3 o'clock in the morning and I hear 12-year-olds while I'm playing GTA 5 at 3 o'clock in the morning. It's like, dude, your balls haven't dropped yet. Can you go to bed?
That's funny. No, dude, oh my God. I'm just, I had to take a break earlier and I was just like, okay, I'll go on my DPS. And I'm like, I don't want a fucking DPS. And yeah, Frasley would get my problem. And obviously you do too. Thank you, buddy. So yeah. Us gamers, right? Beatism.
Yeah. Well, you know, the game that I love playing, it gets a really huge update next week, which is going to be awesome, hopefully. So I can just stop level grinding and actually get some new quests, so I'm pretty excited about it.
Cool.
What game is it?
Fallout 76.
Oh, that's the one with the complete wrong commercial song. Yeah.
Yeah, I
thought that was the hated Fallout that everybody hated it because.
Well, it's for me, it's a fun game to play. It does still have its following, and when it first came out, it was a little broken, yes, but now it's a little different and it's a little getting better with the hot fixes and the updates. And the lack of, basically, it was almost like, it's supposed to be set in West Virginia, but it was pretty much like Australia. It's like Australia because everything's trying to kill you, you know? But now they're bringing back human NPCs, which next week they're supposed to get that very large update to bring back human NPCs and supposed to be like really good, but yeah, there was a lot of glitches and stuff that was broken that Bethesda has fixed, which it's getting better and better by month. It's getting better and better, so I'm pretty happy.
That's cool. I just remember the commercial. It's like an old 60s song and it said 76. I'm like, that's not the right song. I had to look at the song just to make sure I wasn't going nuts. So, then I found $5. Oh, I rhymed. Shout-outs. Out to Diagnosis in the game of World of Warcraft for giving my pet Dusty a lot of meat.
Yeah.
Thank you, Diagnosis.
Your pet put Dusty's meat in its mouth.
So, if you're listening to the live or you're going to listen to the other, thanks. Thanks, Diagnosis. Anybody have any shout-outs? Sid just came online and yells out, COVID-19 party, woo! Nice. All right, next shout-out goes to... I'm sorry.
I got one.
You got one?
Right. Shout-out to my neighbors for not being upset when they hear a saw at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Hell yeah. Mm.
We have so much daylight.
Shout out to Cyric. I hope this ain't a name right. Another shout out to him with goes with diagnosis. Same person gave me even more meat because he got upset while we were talking in party that I'd give him a shout out, diagnosis, on the show. So Cyric gave me a bunch more and goes, "What did you say?" So shout out to Cyric for giving me even more meat for my animal.
Thank you, Cyric.
Give a shout out to the Amazon drivers and delivery drivers for delivering the random shit that I've ordered over the last 2 weeks in a timely manner.
Yes.
You guys are awesome.
Absolutely. And also to all the Uber Eats and Grubhub and Postmates and DinerDash, DoorDash, not DinerDash. DinerDash is the thing where you don't pay. Please pay your waiters and waitresses. But shout out to all the delivery drivers who are like, I feel bad. I can't even thank you other than like the tip in the app, because it's like, okay, you're at my door with the food. Now get away so I can go get it.
Do you use DoorDash or do you use those apps?
Absolutely. I've been using those for many of my meals because...
Oh, that your way... Wendy's Frosties, huh?
Exactly, yeah. And today we picked up Arby's. So I'm actually drinking right now a amazing root beer from Arby's. And I just finished up some curly fries. I've got a cod sandwich next to me. And then there's a chocolate shake for dessert.
Hey, Frazzy, you got to strip your game up, man. You got to just buy the fries straight from the grocery store and cook them in an air fryer.
I don't want to burn my hand.
This is B-Dism. And this is Treat Yourself.
What do you got going on there?
He did promise us one today.
Yeah, today is Taco Tuesday. So.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so I've got some homemade tortillas that I'm working up right now, and got some chips, and I'm making my world famous, well, okay, maybe not world famous, neighborhood famous, shredded chicken taco filler, and yeah, me and the kids are going to sit here and watch some TV, think of all the old good times that I've had, and I miss sports dearly, and going to have some nachos.
I just had sex. I'm about to eat nachos.
Cue my outro.
This has been a treat, 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 treat yourself update.
I love it. Nice.
Shout outs.
Yeah. But Frass, man, you got to get an air fryer, man. Just step up your game, bro.
Shout out to air fryers.
Yeah.
For cooking my tater tots. The reason why I asked about DoorDash unevenly.
Every time I've ever tried to price, like, to order something off DoorDash or one of those apps, it's like, fuck that. I'll just drive and get it. It's $10 more to order something. It's always so expensive.
Wow.
It's always, even when we've ordered, like, group things at work,
it is more expensive.
Always, like, $8 or $10 more.
I give you that.
See, but if I was, like, hammered drunk and I needed some White Castles,
yeah,
I'd pay
whiteies.
That $8 or $10.
Mm-hmm. Give you some whiteies, baby. Yeah. Hey, Fraz.
Yes.
You know how I'm streaming right now in Discord? I should be still. Is there any way that can go up into Twitch? How does that work? Yes. Like when you do your stuff?
Because
I thought that'd be kind of fun. If we're gonna do audio, they'll just put up like you and I just playing stupid video games or B-Dism or something.
Sure.
Or just a picture of a wall. I don't know. Something.
So I'm not. I don't stream on. I don't stream on Twitch. I stream on Mixer.
Oh, Mixer.
Yeah. I need
What's
to stream on Twitch.
Nothing.
It's the same thing, just two different services.
And there's really not a big difference between the two. Like, I'm a Twitch affiliate, so obviously Twitch is I'm in agreement with them, like, and they've been good to me on payouts and stuff like that. But Mixer, the only thing I want is I want both services to innovate more so that way both are going to try to get people to want both of them. Because right now it seems like there's a little bit of stagnation in it. And I want, like, come on, just bring out more.
Okay. Sounds about right, I guess. I'm Ron Burgundy. Oh, they're going to let me die. They're so going to let me die.
I was going to say, I haven't been paying attention. I've been watching you play.
See, this makes sense. So if anybody listens to the show, they're like, oh, he's playing a video game. Like my dad always says. You're playing
I just brought your Discord stream into it.
Oh, cool. Now they get to see this, huh? Ooh. Look at that. See, that's why you get paid the big bucks, Frasley, that I don't.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, my God. You get paid the big bucks that I don't
see,
pay.
This is what I'm saying. Are you seeing this right now, Fras? All these fucking retarded DPS stupid motherfuckers are just like, I'm just going to
agree with you except for the R word. I don't like the R word, but that's.
Motherfucker?
Retard?
Oh, yeah, I don't like that word. Okay, okay. These stupid assholes. How about that?
There we go. You can say stupid asshole as much as you want.
Okay. No, I'm cool with that because I'm with you. I know people who don't like the R word.
And the biggest reason is that word has been used so many times to put people down who do have a developmental disability. And like, I'm like, yeah, so that it's why I hate it's why I hate the word bitch. It's used to. Too many times against females.
Oh, yeah.
And that's why I refuse to say that word. Because
I don't have enough rage, and everybody just starts going nuts.
Listen, I don't say bitch because it's a female, but sometimes
I know.
People act like bitches.
They act like female dogs?
No.
I have just seen enough 100%.
Women.
I've seen people use that word against women. I'm just like, I don't want to say the word whatsoever. That's me. Wow. That's me.
Yeah, but that's what the word is for. If someone's being a fucking asshole, you call them a fucking asshole. You know what I mean? I can see it using it loosely, like, you know, someone using it to bully somebody. That's one thing.
Two words I'm not allowed to say my wife hates is retard and mm-hmm. bitch.
That's why
I don't think I've ever thought about combining the two.
A retarded bitch? Oh. It's like forming Voltron, dude.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Captain Planet. Curse words.
So I put in, when I just put up the show from yesterday, and I put in, remember I was trying to figure out what that name was? It's Captain Power and the Soldiers of the Future. So, yeah. If anybody knows what that is.
Have you seen the Don Cheadle Captain Planet?
Yes.
No.
If you haven't seen it, it's hilarious. It's so good.
All right. Well, right. Do I need more shout outs or anything? I think that's it. I think we kind of covered what we wanted to do for this little thing. Yeah, but that's all I got for today's show. We did another thing, and now we got Frasley.
What Frasley?
Hey, what's up with Frasley?
I need a little Frasley in my life.
Well, every morning I've been watching Twitch. I've been watching Star Trek on Twitch, and tonight after I do a few more things, I will be live again, and we're going to do some WoW. And this past week, I talked with one of my best friends, Spaz Wesson, and later on this, I think it's in May. We've got a special guest on the Frazzlecast, a voice that you just heard a second ago. We've got Polly coming on Frazzlecast.
When?
Let me look at the date.
Sweet.
I love Frazzlecast, dude.
You need to make you some are on, Wallies.
As of right now, on May 14th.
May 14th. Can we talk about BlizzCon?
Absolutely.
Sweet.
Then I will say that I've confirmed that you're available May 14th at 9 p.m. Eastern.
Yeah, live on the show. Thanks, buddy.
Absolutely. It's been a while since I've had you on, and you're always fun to talk with.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I'm finishing up the editing for your stuff that we did on your stuff.
Was amazing. All the songs that you did, and like you're trying to stump me on songs, and I realized how much I don't know about music.
Yeah, dude, because you're all like, man, come on, Paul. I'm a lot older than I think. And I was like, all right, cool. And then all of a sudden, bam, your listeners and your viewers, man, they know a lot about some music.
So, oh, yes.
So that was pretty cool. That was a good time. And I earned little frazzle dazzles. So I'm happy about that. Hydrate.
Hey, Frazzly, are you live tonight?
Yep, I'll be live probably around 7 or 8.
Oh, okay.
I'm finishing up.
I got to earn some more.
Ooh, yes. That way you can hydrate, feed chocolate.
That's what Fraz is doing. That's what Fraz is doing.
I think I get it.
Everybody, right. Please send us comments, likes, everything. Thank you for all the shout outs. Thank you for all the stuff, Jenny K. But yeah, go to the website. Yeah, check K, out.
Thanks for listening.
Yes. Go to the website, miscellaneouspodcast.org. You see it down in the show notes. Please give us some comments, reviews, whatever, likes, everything. Get us going. Get us the flagship going so that we can just keep this rolling, because this is a fun thing we do and we like to keep going. So from all of us here at the Miscellaneous Podcast, one more thing I forgot to say is go to Norco Killer's Twitter.
Follow me and retweet the pinned tweet about the Stanley Patina Pop, and you could be selected by Paulie to win that. We are going to, I don't know, when we want to give that one away, because we're just going to have to give it to somebody that's in there.
Well, let's give it a little time, I think. Let's play around with it. Let's give it a little time. If somebody starts getting antsy, we'll worry about that later. But for right now, let's try to get more people in there. What do you think?
All right, whatever.
All right. Come on, people. Let's get into it. Dude, go to Norco Killers. It's all caps, at Norco Killer on Twitter. Because that's where most of us hang out and do stupid things. So you can contact us directly if you want.
And I haven't been up to date on it, so I'm glad you dropped that one in there this morning, Paul. Thank you.
I'm there for you, buddy. All right. So from all of us here at the Miscellaneous Podcast, good night, everyone.
Night.
Peace be with you.
Good night.
Goodbye.
Thanks.
Mr. Man.